Paleolithic Era, a period with a span longer than all of recorded history combined. We are talking about an astounding 3 million years. Let's turn back time and explore the era commonly known as the Old Stone Age. Today, we will check out the hardships of early human life, how they used their ingenuity to survive for so long, and amaze ourselves with the magnificent art they left behind. So what precisely characterizes the Paleolithic era? Well, the name itself is a hint. It originates from the ancient Greek words for old and stone. It is so far proved to have started around 3.3 million years ago and extended all the way back to the conclusion of the Pleistocene epoch, roughly 11,650 years before the present. The beginning of this era is marked by the very first use of stone tools, hence why it belongs to the Stone Age. This huge span of human prehistory encompasses remarkable breakthroughs in tool technology, social structures, and creative expression. To better comprehend this lengthy span of time, archaeologists have separated the Paleolithic era into three different periods: the Lower, Middle, and Upper Paleolithic. Each phase is marked by an evolution in the sophistication of the stone tools made by the hominin species of that time. The division of this era into three different periods is similar to how our generations are separated by major cultural shifts. The Lower Paleolithic, ranging from around 3.3 million years ago to nearly 200,000 years ago, represents the largest chunk of time from this era and the beginning of our adventure with stone tools. During the span of these roughly 2.8 million years, early hominins, such as Homo habilis and Homo erectus, put together relatively primitive tools. Their implements were rudimentary, yet effective. The simplicity of these tools was as basic as splitting a stone with a big rock called a chopper to generate a sharp edge core tool with a usable point. Hand axes and cleavers were made by hitting stones together through a method called knapping. These functioned for cutting, scraping, and slaughtering. These early tools served for numerous tasks, from butchering animal corpses to cutting wood and digging. Now, the Middle Paleolithic era featured the biggest development in tool-making methods, extending from roughly 200,000 years ago to 40,000 years ago. Neanderthals, the dominant hominins of this age, were excellent in the craft of the Mousterian method. They could strategically flake stones to form well-defined hand axes, points, and scrapers. These more polished tools allowed for a greater variety of activities, including more efficient hunting, creating wooden implements, and processing skins for clothes and shelter. Toolkits acquired a higher complexity, like the spear points that were used for hunting and the specialized scrapers used for preparing skins. But the true revolutionary advancements in tool technology happened during the Upper Paleolithic era, which lasted from around 40,000 years ago until 11,650 years ago. That's around 28,000 years in total. This period witnessed the birth of Homo sapiens, modern humans, who demonstrated a considerably more advanced tool-making method. Tools became not just more complicated, but also more specialized. Barbed spear tips for hunting, sewing needles made from bone that enable better manufacture of tailored clothes, a game changer for surviving frigid conditions, and harpoons for effective fishing. These early humans began to build composite tools, mixing various materials tailored for specific tasks. Even tools with handles for improved leverage are all unique characteristics of the Upper Paleolithic. These advances illustrate the extraordinary creativity of our Paleolithic predecessors. This era is a monument to the resourcefulness and adaptability of our early ancestors. Through the innovation of stone tools, not only did they ensure their survival, but also created a framework for future technological breakthroughs that would change the trajectory of human history. Intriguingly, because this era lasted for such a long period of time, it made anthropologists wonder if the different species of ancestors could have ever met and interacted with each other. As many of you know, Homo sapiens were not the only human species around throughout the Paleolithic era. Two of the most well-known examples are a close cousin of ours, Neanderthals, and a less well-understood population, Denisovans. Neanderthals occupied portions of Europe and Asia for hundreds of thousands of years, alongside early humans. and Denisovans are believed to have also interbred with Homo sapiens. What is even more fascinating is that these encounters and inbreeding may have affected the evolution of modern humans. A genetic study run by the Swedish geneticist Svante Paabo, winner of the 2022 Nobel Prize, suggests that some contemporary humans inherited genes from Neanderthals and Denisovans, whose fossils are found in Europe and Asia. These genes may have provided humans with adaptations to varied environments or resistance to specific illnesses. Maybe this could explain why some humans are more prone to catching a cold than others. So if you ever take a genealogy test, you might just uncover a trace of a Neanderthal cousin hiding in your family tree. If you like learning about the fascinating history of our species, make sure to subscribe. We release two interesting topics per week. One of the most astonishing aspects of the Paleolithic era is the emergence of art. Stunning sculptures like the Venus of Willendorf date back to this time. This 25,000-year-old figure, carved from mammoth ivory, represents a lady with exaggerated characteristics, including breasts, buttocks, and a tummy. The Paleolithic also holds some of our oldest cave paintings, like those in the Spanish caves of La Pasiega, the district of Maros in Sulawesi, Indonesia, the Chauvet Caves in France, and Lascaux, and a red hand stencil from the Maltarviesco cave in Casares, Spain, to name a few. These paintings include pictures of animals, intricate hunting scenes, and strange symbols that are still being decoded. Most of all, this art shows that even when life was tough, early humans had a rich culture and deep appreciation for the world around them. It's actually not surprising that paintings from this period can be found in sites all around the globe, because our ancestors were continuously on the move and did not live in stable settlements. Their groups, numbering between 20 to 50 people, had to survive in equilibrium with their surroundings. Unlike rooted societies that could build up stocks of food and create solid borders, their nomadic existence centered on the continuous variation of resource availability. But this wasn't chaotic nor aimless roaming. Nomadic communities were constantly aware of the rhythms and changes in their environment. Their migratory habits were regulated by the changing seasons, just as birds understand migration through seasonal movement, a well-rehearsed show performed year after year. These groups would move their homes, built for mobility and easy setup, depending on the availability of food sources, because they were hunter-gatherers relying on natural foods and animals for sustenance. Every member, young and old, played a key part in the group's survival, and evidence so far shows that there was a distinct division of work depending on gender. Men presumably concentrated on hunting huge animals, a risky but important chore for survival. Large prey would have offered not only food, but also skins for clothing and shelter, and bones for crafts and weapons. Women and children, on the other hand, may have been responsible for harvesting plant materials, fruits, insects, and seafood. This collection would have required comprehensive knowledge of local flora and wildlife, making it a crucial contribution to the group's survival. The magnitude of these migratory tribes speaks much about their adaptability. Large numbers just wouldn't have been sustained without a close-knit organization, one that promoted a strong sense of community, where collaboration and resource sharing was vital. Some important abilities that these nomads had included being able to read the natural environment, foresee the movements of animal herds, learn the shifting patterns of plant growth, but most impacting of all, communicate. Research on brain development, tool complexity, and symbolic behavior in early humans is ongoing, but it suggests the possibility of spoken language existing in the late Paleolithic era. Early humans may have had some type of verbal communication that greatly differs from our language today. Yet with revolutionary tools, an interest in art, and even a form of communication, life in the Paleolithic era was far from easy. Food was sparse, danger lurked around every turn, and let's not forget that the temperature was unpredictable. And we're not talking about the heavy rain, scorching sun, snow, and wind we get in one day. The end of this fascinating era is marked by the Pleistocene epoch, a geographical age defined by the recurrent cycles of glaciation. Evidence shows that approximately 15,000 years ago, melting glaciers formed land bridges between continents, enabling our ancestors to travel to new locations, including the Americas, for the first time. The formation of these ice sheets had a tremendous influence on the ecology. Huge glaciers dominated most of the world, driving back forests and forming huge freezing plains. Therefore, early human motivation to travel far distances could be due to the terrain in which they lived. A large desert or a spreading tundra couldn't sustain a stable colony, so following the paths of certain animal populations could ensure a continual supply of meat and skins. Hominins of this period successfully adapted to these difficult circumstances by constantly seeking new sources of food and shelter. The hardships of chasing gigantic mammoths across a frozen environment or locating food plants during a cold winter is not far from the truth. Imagine a planet very different from our own. Glaciers everywhere, and the breathtaking sight of enormous species like woolly mammoths. It is amazing how early human inventiveness provided the groundwork for all that followed later, turning us into the modern beings we are today. So, how would you survive during this time? Check out our other videos where we learn how our ancestors survived the Ice Age and skillfully hunted for food. Subscribe to take a detailed tour of our primitive history.